Welcome to Analyze This for Power BI. This video is part of a series that helps make sense of the myriad of options in Microsoft's business intelligence platform. In this video, we discuss Power BI Dataflows. This is a pretty cool method for building and sharing query logic for others to use. Now, if you haven't watched the Power BI data management video, I suggest you do that first so that this one will make more sense. Okay, let's talk about data flows. These look very much like a data set, but they work like an ETL integration tool. All right, an ETL stands for extract, transform, and load, right? Now, we build data flows using Power Query, and much like building a data set. We grab data from one or more data sources, we transform the data using Power Query steps and commands, and then we store the data. And here's where it's different from a data set, because data flows don't use Power BI storage. They store their data outside of Power BI in either Azure Data Lake or in Dataverse. Once the data flow is created, it shows up as a data component, and our Power BI users can use the data flow's tables and columns to build new Power BI datasets and reports, just like if they were to query the data source themselves. Interesting, isn't it? And this is usually the point where someone looks at me with narrowed eyes and says, if it's just like building a data set, then why would I use a data flow instead of building a data set? And that's a really good question. Well, data flows are a nice solution if, one, you know Power Query, and you want to solve a unique query request, like maybe combining a data warehouse with some spreadsheets, and that's not something everyone can do, and you want to share those results with multiple users. But here's where it becomes different from a data set. What if the query that you need to build, this data flow, is going to result in a very large data set, and you don't want to use up Power BI storage for that? Or, suppose you want to build this data set, and you don't just want to share it with Power BI users, but you also want to share it with people building Power Apps and Power Automate applications, and therefore you want it in Dataverse. And that's why you would use a data flow instead of a data set. You could perform the same steps using something like Azure Data Factory or SQL Server Integration Services, but both of those tools require setting up a new service and advanced features, and you really have to know what you're doing in those tools. And so Dataflows is really designed for Power BI users who want to create an integration process. Now, here's the rest that you need to know. Dataflows reside within a workspace, so they are shared the same way as you would share a data set, which is nice. And because they use external storage, either Azure Data Lake or Dataverse, your choice, you'll have to pay for that storage separately. It's not included in your Power BI subscription, so you really only want to use this if you have a need to have this stored outside of Power BI. Personally, I see Dataflows as a really nice tool for a very specific set of requirements. Okay, I hope this video clears up what data flows are and aren't, and how they fit within a Power BI deployment, and when you would actually want to use them. Now, this video series can be viewed in any order, but if you need a recommendation, I suggest you watch the Power BI Data Marts video next.